everyone. Today's model question is regarding ocean currents and hot deserts. So this is a pair type of question, and on one side we have been given the ocean currents, and we have to find out which of these ocean currents influence the formation of hot deserts, right? So let's take a look at the major hot deserts of the world. So if you start from the North America, right, we are having the deserts here. One example is Mojave Desert, and we got the in South America, we got the Atacama Desert, as well as Patagonian Desert here, right? Then moving towards the Africa, we got the Sahara Desert, as well as Namib and Kalahari Desert towards the Southern Africa, right? And in the West Asian regions, we are having the Arabian Desert, the Thar Desert, Iranian Desert and all. And towards the Australian regions, we are having the Great Australian Desert. Right, so these are the major hot deserts, and if you look at the location of these deserts, right, most of these deserts, they're located towards the western margins of the continents, be it the case of Atacama or like Mojave Desert or Sahara or Namib. All these deserts, they are towards the western margin of the continent, right? Plus, if you look at these deserts, they're not along the equator. So we have studied that, you know, along the equator we are receiving more temperature. But, you know, going by that logic, the desert should be forming over these equator regions, right? But that's not the case. These deserts, they are towards the western margin, plus they are along the subtropical high pressure belt, or they are near to Tropic of Cancer as well as Capricorn, right? So these are the certain properties of these location of deserts, right? You have to remember that they are along the western margins of the continents, plus, they are along the subtropical high pressure belt regions, right? We are having certain exceptions like the Gobi Desert or Turkestan Desert, right, towards the Siberian, as well as like, you know, these central regions, right? So those are influenced by the interior location, right? They are towards the interior of the continents, so there is no way the moisture can reach them, right? Now if you go through the factors influencing these desert formation, right, why are they seen near to the coastal regions, right? Going by the symbol logic, near to the coastal regions, we should be having more rainfall, but that's not the case, right? Now, these deserts, they are influenced by mainly three factors. One of them is the ocean currents, right? All of these deserts, right, they are influenced by cold oceanic currents. If you look at the case of Mojave Desert, which is there in the North American regions, the current there along that coast is Californian current, which is cold current. It's moving from the polar regions towards the equator regions, right? All the currents which are moving from the polar regions, generally, right, from the polar regions towards the equator regions, we will be having cold current. Now, if you look at the Atacama Desert, right, the cold current there is the Peruvian or the Humboldt current. And in the case of like the Namib or Kalahari Desert, we are having the Benguela current. And in the case of the Saharan Desert, we are having the Canaries current. And if you look at the Great Australian Desert, the cold oceanic current influencing the Great Australian Desert is West Australian Cold Current. So all these deserts, if you are being asked why are they located along the western margins of the continents, one reason is that like the cold currents are flowing through these regions, right? So the cold current means the ocean water, it will also be cold, right? These regions, the ocean water, it will be cold. And this cold ocean water will be having less capacity to carry moisture. Or in other sense, right, warm air can carry more moisture when compared with the cold air. So since we are having cold oceanic currents, the air here also will be cold, so that the capacity to like carry moisture will be less over these regions. And that is how the cold oceanic currents are influencing the formation of major hot deserts. Plus, like the cold air here, it will be more denser, right? And the denser the air, it won't rise up. It will stay there itself, right? If you look at the case of an hydrogen balloon, if you leave an hydrogen balloon, it will always go upward, right? Why? Because the hydrogen is having less density when compared with the surrounding air particles, right? Same way, if an air is more denser, right, if an air is more colder, it will be more denser, as well as it will stay near to the surface, right? For all these reasons, like the major hot deserts, they are located along the western margin, mainly because of the influenced by cold oceanic currents. Now going through other main factors which are influencing the location of like the cold current, location of the major hot deserts. One of the major reasons is a subtropical high pressure belt, right? Now if you look at the subtropical high pressure belt, or like, you know, in these regions we will be having the winds moving from the upper troposphere towards the surface, right? If you are having high pressure regions, the winds will be subsiding. And if you are having low pressure regions, like in the case of equatorial low, the air will be ascending, right? Air will be moving upward. And the equatorial low regions, they are, I mean, those regions we are having high rainfall, right? Because the air is ascending. So when the air is ascending, it will be carrying moisture towards the upper atmosphere, creating clouds and giving precipitation. Unlike this, in the subtropical high pressure regions, right, the air is subsiding. So if the air is subsiding, in the sense air is moving from the upper troposphere towards the surface, right? So it won't, I mean, it's not a favorable condition for the formation of clouds. So in that scenario, if you're having high pressure belt, right, or if you're having high pressure regions, the precipitation will be reduced. And all the deserts, they are located along the subtropical high pressure belt regions. In this picture, right, this is a picture of like Africa, and you can see the Saharan desert is located along the subtropical high pressure belt. Same way, I mean, same explanation can be said for the case of Namib as well as Kalahari desert, right? Now, so one reason is the major hot deserts, they're influenced by cold oceanic current. And the second reason we have discussed is a case of subtropical high pressure belt, right? Now, the third reason is the onshore and offshore nature of the prevailing winds. Onshore means towards shore. So the winds will be carrying the moisture towards the continents and it will give more precipitation, right? Offshore means leaving the shore, right? So, I mean, the winds are blowing from continents towards the ocean. In that case, the precipitation will be reduced, right? Now, in these latitudes where the major hot deserts are seen, right? Like, you know, the winds blowing them or the prevailing winds there, they are the trade winds, right? All the trade winds, they'll be blowing from, generally from east towards the west, right? So if you're considering the case of the Atacama Desert, the trade wind, they're blowing from the east towards the west. So towards the, in the eastern margins, the trade winds, they are onshore, meaning that they're moving from the oceans towards the continent, right? So the trade winds are onshore towards the eastern margin. But if you're considering the western margin of a continent, the trade wind, they're moving from the continent towards the ocean. And in that scenario, the precipitation will be discouraged. So in all the, in all the major hot deserts, if you're being asked why they are located along the western margin, the reasons are like one, the cold oceanic current, and the second reason is the offshore nature of trade wind, right? Now there is another property, another thing to note down here. If you're considering the South America, right? One desert I have discussed is the case of Atacama Desert, which is over the western margin. At the same way, we are having another desert along the eastern margin, which is Patagonian desert, right? As you can see here in the second picture, right? So in this case of Patagonian desert, it's influenced by the westerly winds, right? Westerlies, they are blowing from west to east. So the westerly winds, they are onshore along the western margin and they are offshore along the eastern margin, right? So like again to bring them into perspective, right? The trade winds, they are onshore along the eastern margin and they're offshore along the western margin. So in the trade wind belt regime, right, the deserts are formed along the western margin. And in the case of like the westerlies, they are onshore along the western margin and offshore along the eastern margin. And for that reason, the Patagonian desert is located towards the eastern margin. So the major reasons influencing the hot deserts, they are like, you know, the cold oceanic currents, as well as like the high pressure belt regions where the air is subsiding, and the offshore nature of trade winds or the prevailing winds, you can say. So coming back to the question, right? So it's a pair type of question, and we have to find out which of them is correctly paired, right? So the first one, Benguela current is matched with the Namib desert. We have already seen that the Namib desert, the cold oceanic current here is the Benguela current. So that one is correct, right? So we can eliminate option C. The second one, Californian current is matched with Mojave Desert. So the Mojave Desert is along the western coast of North America, and the cold oceanic current here is the Californian current, which is again correct, right? So 1 and 2 should be there, and so we can eliminate A as well as C. So let's go through the third statement, right? Canaries current, and it's matched with Saharan Desert. Right, like the Canaries current, here the cold oceanic current is Canaries current, and there we are having the Saharan desert. So in this particular model question, all three statements, they are correctly paired, and the answer comes out as D, which is 1, 2 and 3.